बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम रब्बी शरहली सदरी वयस्सिरली अमरी वहलुल उक़दतम मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हू क़ौली रब्बी ज़िदनी इल्मा। डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज डॉक्टर मोहम्मद इकबाल, योर कोर्स इंस्ट्रक्टर, स्टैंडर्ड सेटिंग इन असेसमेंट। यू नो, वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स रिगार्डिंग द स्टैंडर्ड सेटिंग methods which are given by various experts. This is my 12th lecture, and in this lecture I will discuss Hofstede and Buick method with you. Dear students, first of all, I will discuss with you the background of these standard setting methods. There are various ways to set a defensible cut score or a professional pre-employment tests by organization for the quality of their examinations by applying international standards for test development, like the standards made by the National Commission for Certifying, NCCA. One component of the standard setting methods known as cut score studies, one of the most respected approach for that is the modified Engoff method. This is the method which we studied in the previous lectures. Dear students, however, the Engoff approach has one flaw, which is the subject matter experts tend to expect too much out of minimally competent candidates, and sometimes set a cut score so high that even they themselves would not pass the exam. It means it is their fault. It is the flaw of this method. The subject matter experts wanted to expect too much from the minimally competent candidates. And sometimes they make so much difficult cut score are so high that even they themselves would not pass the exam. For this reason, several compromises tests have been suggested to compare the Engoff recommended cut score with the reality check of the actual score performance on the exam, allowing the subject matter experts to make a more informed decision when setting the official cut scores of the exam. So this was the need on the base of this new compromising method was origin. These compromising methods are Hofstede and Buick method, which I am going to discuss with you. Dear students, now I will introduce to you about the Hofstede method. Hofstede's 1983 compromise method began as an invented to address the practical problems of conflicting criterion and norm reference expectations. In a paper describing the development of the method, Hofstede described a situation he faced in 1979 in the course of administering an examination in research methods to 160 second year students. own this situation. When he gave this test, the only 60% students could pass the test. So this institution became the background of inventing or making the Hofstede method of standard setting. So this method is that in which judge decide on the maximum and minimum failure rate and acceptable pass marks. One method of adjusting the cut score based on raters' impressions of difficulty of the test and possibly pass rates is the Hofstede method. Mills, Milken, 1987, Cizik, 2006, Burr et al., 2016. The Hofstede judgmental task requires each standard setting participant to four questions and assume that examinees are the first time test takers. Two of the questions focus on the acceptable knowledge level of examinees. This he symbolizes K. While the other two questions focus on the tolerable examination failure rates, this Hofstede symbolizes symbol F. So, the Hofstede method requires the raters to estimate following four values as pointed out in the previous questions. Number one, the minimum acceptable failure rate. Number two, the maximum acceptable failure rate. Number three, the maximum cut score even if all examinees failed. And number four, the maximum cut scores even if all examinees failed. So these are four instances the Hofstede requires from the raters. Dear students, now I will come towards the procedure for the implementing the Hofstede method. Dear students, this task requires each standard setting participant to respond to four questions and to assume that examinees are the first time test takers. The four questions asked from participants about the following. Number one. What is the highest percent correct cut score that would be acceptable? He symbolizes as K maximum. Number two, what is the lowest percent of correct cut score that would be acceptable? He symbolizes as K minimum. Question third, what is the maximum acceptable failure rate? Symbolizes as F maximum. Question number four, what is the minimum acceptable failure rate? Symbolizes as F minimum. Dear student, Hofstede explained this phenomena with a figure. First of all, I will explain the figure and then I will present the that figure. Explanation of figure 12.1. It is given on the your book page number 210. The following figure 12.1 illustrates a hypothetical application of Hofstede method. Hypothetical mean fuzzy, in which the mean of participants' judgments about K minimum, K maximum, F minimum and F maximum are approximately 32.580, 80 and 12.5 and 90 respectively. Ordered pairs of the point K minimum and F maximum and K maximum and F minimum, which corresponding to the point 32.5 and 90 and 80, 12.5 are used to plot a line. These coordinates have been identified in figure, and the resulting straight line between these points running from upper left to lower right of the graph, which you will see in the figure, coming figure. Hofstede said along this line that all compromise solutions to the cut score may be found. Dear students, now you will look into the figure which Hofstede presented to explain the Hofstede method of standards setting. So this is the figure. On x-axis, percentage failing, these are deciles from 0 to 100, and on y-axis, adjusted percentage current required 0 to 100 with the interval of 5. Illustration of Hofstede cut scores derivations. So there is a line from upper to lower, K minimum, F maximum, it corresponds to 90, and the F in the lower side, K maximum, F minimum. This line correspond on x-axis 12.5. So this way the Hofstede explain this method. Of compromises standard setting. Dear students, now I will move towards the second method, Buick method. Buick method is also a compromising method, which is little bit different from the Hofstede. Hofstede method was focusing on four questions or four situations, but instead of the Hofstede method, the Buick method rests in two assumptions. One about the participants in the standard setting process, and one about the process should be configured. Again, I am repeating, the Buick method rests in two assumptions. It focuses on two assumptions. One about the participants in the standard setting process, and the other about the process should be configured. according to Buick, assumed that what passing score should be required. He symbolized as X. Number two, what pass rates can be expected? He symbolized as Y. Dear students, he explained the standard setting method, this compromising standard setting method, Buick. On x-axis, he puts passing rates with the deciles, intervals of deciles, and on the x-axis, he presented percentages of correct required. So these are 1, 11, 22, 21, 31, 41, 51, 61, 71, 81, and 91. So this is the figure 12.2, and it is explained, it is given on your book page number 214. Dear students, these were the two methods which are called compromising methods and based on practical problems of the Hofstede and Buick's while making standard setting. And so these both methods have some certain limitations, which I will present. Dear student, the following are the limitations of these both methods. Number one, the method include 4 for Hofstede method and 2 for Buick method questions in the final procedural evaluation. Both methods were developed in the context of examinations in which only pass-fail decisions was necessary. It means they were focusing on the pass fail only, not proficient or advanced or not so other. So this is their limitation. Number two, we have to use Hofstede and Buick method in conjunction with other standard setting procedure. It is its limitation. The Hofstede method does not involve rating of every single item. So many subject matter experts recommended that it should be used in concert with Engoff and Buick method. So we can't use them in isolation or as a single method. We should use this method with the Hofstede method with the Engoff recommended Engoff extended method. So it's drawback. So dear students, these were the two methods which I presented before you. The first was Hofstede method and the second was Buick method. So I discuss the concepts and steps of these methods and also limitations of these both methods. And in my next lecture, I will present some other method. So thank you for your consideration and for your precious time. Assalamu alaikum.